Hi all, I am Mr. Vinod Atkari, Assistant Professor, Department of Agricultural Engineering, Don Bosco College of Agriculture, Sulkarna, Kepe, Goa. Today I will take fourth module of course Soil and Water Conservation Engineering, having course code Engineering 121 for second semester of first year BSc Agricultural Honours. The module name is Land Use Capability Classification and Planning. The outline of module is Land Capability Groups, Land Capability Classes. At the end of this module, students will learn different land capability groups and their classification. So, what is mean by land capability? Land capability is the suitability of that land for use, so many uses without any damage to that land. The land capability classification is a systematic grouping of different kinds of land for sustained productivity. So, land and soil. What is mean by land? Land refers to the delineated part of the earth surface considered in its entirety. All these plains, swamps, wetlands, upland, mountains, rivers, coastal regions, deserts also, all comes under the land. But what is mean by soil? Soil is the ecosystem comprising mainly weathered rock, organic matter and microorganisms. A proper land use could be planned having regard to its suitability and capability classification. In view of rapidly increasing need for more food production, use of land by different types of users, it is necessary to accord priority to the optimum land use and its conservation. So the land capability groups, there are two groups are there, arable land and non-arable. Arable land means cultivable land, non-arable means it's not suitable for normal cultivation. Arable land comprise land suitable for cultivation and other uses. These groups include first four classes of land capability, that is class 1, class 2, class 3 and class 4. And non-arable land means the land which is not suitable for regular cultivation but suitable for other uses like plantation crops or for cultivation of horticultural crops or growing forestry, wildlife creation, etc. This land includes class 5, 6, 7 and 8. Land capability classes. The USDA, that is United States Department of Agriculture, proposed this land capability classification. They classified the land into 8 groups. First 4 groups are, that is from class 1 to class 4, are suitable for regular cultivation, means it is called as arable land. Remaining 4 classes, that is from 5th to 8th, comprise the land which is not suitable for regular cultivation, means non-arable land. Here in this table, this land capability classification is given from class 1 to class 8. These Roman numbers 1 to up to 8 gives the class numbers and it is denoted by this different color on the land capability map. Class 1 is denoted by green color, class 2 is denoted by yellow color, class 3 is red color, likewise for class 8 it is purple. As shown in this chart, there are 8 land capability classification, class 1, class 2 up to class 8, and here the uses of this land is given: wildlife, forestry, then limited, moderate, grazing is there, then cultivation. So class 1 land is suitable for all the purpose, start from cultivation, grazing, also for wildlife. But if you consider this class 8, it is only suitable for wildlife, even though it is not suitable for grazing and cultivation. Land suited for agriculture, that is class, we will classify now the in details this land capability group from class 1 to class 8. Class 1 having slope varies from 0 to 1%. This land is good for cultivation by adopting different farming practices or agronomical practices. Level land, which does not easily erode by water. Soil has good water holding capacity as well as drained and can be cropped intensively with adequate supply of fertilizers and organic matter. Then class 2, the slope of this class is varies from 1 to 3%. This soil is good and having slight susceptibility to the erosion because of the gentle slope, that is 1 to 3%. The depth of the soil varies from 22.5 to 45 centimeter. The moderate wetness is there and slow drainage. Water holding capacity for this class second is fair. It requires contour bunding or terracing or contour cultivation for cultivating the crops in that land. Then class third, that the slope of this third class is varies from 3 to 5%. Means moderate slope is there. This soil is moderately good for cultivation, but there are some limitations. High susceptibility to the erosion. The depth of soil is shallow, varies from 7.5 centimeter to 22.5 centimeter. The water holding capacity is also low, means frequent irrigation requires there. Then class number 4, having slope varies from 5 to 10%. Here slope is increasing. Serious limitation of cropping is there. Here there is a requirement of careful and efficient management practices for growing the crops. Next, B part, that is the land suited for permanent vegetation, that is the class 5 to 8. Class 5, slope varies for this class is 15 to 25%. The cultivation is not feasible due to the stoniness or wetness, and other limitations are there. Class 6, next, slope varies from 25 to 33%. Slope, as we proceed with class, slope is increasing. These slopes are subject to moderate and permanent limitations for cultivation. Having the soil depth is also very shallow, steep slope is there. So here we can use this soil only for grazing and forestry purpose if it is properly managed. Then class 7, that is slope varies from 33 to 50%. These soils are very steep, rough, and it is eroded, shallow, then droughty in nature or swampy in nature. Limitations for grazing or forestry. Controlled grazing can be possible if rainfall is sufficient. It can be also used for forestry. And last class, that is class 8, having slope is more than 50%. So these lands unfit for even for grazing or intensive forestry. It can be used. These lands includes marshes, deserts, deep gullies, high mountains, and stony barren areas. These are the references. Thank you.